Okay, now we're talking about chemical reactions. Your cells are constantly carrying out billions of chemical reactions. Every time your cells make energy, every time your cells use energy, when your cells repair themselves, when you're growing, these all involve chemical reactions. A chemical reaction is defined as the making or breaking of a chemical bond. So, in order to understand chemical reactions, we have to talk about how chemical bonds are made. Remember this rough drawing of an atom? The nucleus is tiny, and it's hidden away in the center of an atom. If the nucleus were about the size of a marble, the electrons would be 2 miles away. So when we talk about atoms interacting, we're really talking about the electrons interacting. The protons and neutrons don't usually change. They're buried far too deep inside the atom. But the electrons, they're out there, and they get shuffled around when atoms interact. It's the electrons that form chemical bonds. There are two main types of chemical bonds I want to discuss, ionic bonds and covalent bonds. These two sketches show you what happens to the electrons when these bonds are made. See those little E minus? That represents an electron, the E for electron, and the minus indicates the negative charge on that electron. Ionic bonds are formed when one atom gives an electron to another. Table salt is a great example of an ionic compound. Sodium really wants to get rid of one electron. Chlorine really needs an electron. It's a match made in chemistry heaven. Before atoms form bonds, they are electrically neutral. They have equal numbers of protons and electrons. See how sodium has 11 protons and 11 electrons, and chlorine has 17 protons and 17 electrons. So both of these atoms have equal numbers of positive and negative charges. When an ionic bond is formed, one atom loses an electron, and the other atom gains an electron. These atoms now have charges. The atom that lost an electron now has one extra proton and a positive charge. The atom that gained an electron now has one extra electron, and it has a negative charge. Atoms with a charge are called ions. That's why it's called an ionic bond, because it makes ions. In table salt, sodium becomes the positively charged ion, and chlorine becomes the negatively charged ion, called chloride now. In water, like in our body fluids, ionic compounds separate into their ions. This separation into ions is called dissociation. Compounds that dissociate into ions are called electrolytes. The term electrolytes comes from the fact that ions conduct electricity. So, if you're talking about an electrolyte-containing solution, like an IV bag for rehydrating patients, or like Gatorade, you're talking about a drink that's packed full of these charged ions. The second type of chemical bond I want to discuss is covalent bonding. In covalent bonds, electrons are shared by two atomic nuclei, so the electrons now circle around both nuclei. Here's an example of a covalent compound, methane. Carbon really likes to form covalent bonds. In methane, carbon forms 4 covalent bonds with hydrogen. So you have an electron pair circling carbon and this hydrogen, carbon and this hydrogen, a pair going around carbon and this hydrogen, and that one. A covalent bond holds the nuclei tightly together. These compounds don't dissociate in water. Glucose is another common covalent molecule we'll be discussing. When you dissolve glucose in water, it's still glucose. When atoms combine covalently, they form molecules. So you can think of molecules basically as clusters of bonded atoms. Some of the nutrients we'll be discussing are large biological molecules called polymers. Specifically, it's polysaccharides, a category of carbohydrates, and proteins that are polymers. polymers are made when you string a number of smaller, similar molecules together. Think of it like a bunch of pop beads stuck together by covalent bonds. Each bead is a monomer. Here we have a green monomer and a red monomer. And when you string a bunch of them together, you get a polymer. When you digest these large polymers in food, your digestive enzymes break the polymers down into their constituent monomers. And it's the monomers that actually get absorbed into the bloodstream.